everybody. Chester here, the ultimate storytelling with Miss Pris, the Million Dollar Dog. Wheels out on a Sunday night here walking out. It's so beautiful out here at the Krispy Kreme place. Hey, look, folks, if you ever went through life and felt like you just didn't get the whole thing, or you didn't get the whole story, but you will find out through this video, you're going to get the whole thing. And look, I got a story for you. There was a guy that lived down in my neighborhood when I was coming up named Tony. Well, you know, Tony, he was country. And what I mean by country, he was more country than me. I mean, Tony, he talked like that right now. I mean, you know, he was like wood burning the stove, no natural gas country. And Tony was the type of person, you'd invite him in for dinner, and he didn't call it dinner, he called her supper. He would eat anything on the table. I mean, I'm telling you what, if you wanted to clean out your refrigerator, just call Tony over and it was done. So he'd come over one night and he'd eat enough to kill a 1,200-pound mule. And I said, Tony, I've just got a hankering. I'd love to have some of those hot Krispy Kreme donuts. I kind of said it out of meanness because it was about 20 miles away. And Tony said, boy, oh boy, I'd love to have, they just melt your mouth, don't it? I said, well, let's get in the car and go. So we jump up in the car and go, and the whole time up there, he was talking about them Krispy Kreme donuts. Well, we got up to Krispy Kreme, and I went in there, and I got an assorted dozen for me, my wife, and two young'uns, and Tony, he got a dozen. Well, I was just assured that he was just going to get a dozen for eating for several later. After eating all that at my house, he comes out there and had a little picnic table, because we're sitting here now at a little picnic table like you at the Krispy Kreme. And Tony sat down and popped that donut top of me. He said, golly boy, oh boy, ain't this something. He said, they just melting in my mouth. Well, he started eating, and you know, I eat one or two because they're extremely rich. It was hot right off the press. And the young'uns eat one, and then I sat down and watched him, and I says, man, is Tony gonna eat all them donuts? He ate the whole dozen of donuts, and you would expect that Tony would say something like, man, I'm so full, maybe I shouldn't eat that. He turned and looked at me with a puzzled look, and he said, wonder what they do with the whole. And I said, Tony, you've eaten a dozen donuts. What does it make any difference? He says, because when I was eating that dozen donuts, you know, I felt like I was going around in a circle. But if they'd have put that hole right in there, I could eat it like a cake. Folks, sometimes when you're out there on this internet and you're eating in a circle, you're going round and round, you never get to the meat of what you need to know. So that's why the ultimate storytelling, Miss Pris right here, the Million Dollar Dog, we just talk straight to you. We just want you to know that you can have the whole thing. Look, folks, there's a button right beside my head right here that says, watch it now. Hit that button, go in, let me tell you what's gonna happen. There's gonna be a guy on the other side of that button that was a bankrupt loser 5 years ago. And he learned what 2% of the people on the internet know, and he's gonna tell you exactly what he done. And then you can do what he done, and then you can have what he had. You know, can you imagine, instead of jumping in the car going to Krispy Kreme donuts, if we could have jumped in the car and jumped on a plane and went to Hawaii? Or maybe down to your dream vacation. Maybe your dream's not a vacation. Maybe your dream is just to have the car you've always really wanted to drive. You know, not one you'd beat with a Pepsi Cola bottle to get the thing started. Maybe it'd be one when you just sat down in that leather, could just wrap around the side of your legs and you could just smell that leather. Maybe you look right down on the dash and you see those pretty off-green neon glowing dash lights right there that don't look like yours is dimmed out right now. You know, maybe it's to go to a nice clothing store and just get what you wanted, what felt right, not what was on sale. Or maybe it was just to go to a restaurant instead of reading from right to left, read from left to right. And what I mean by that, folks, is most people go to a restaurant and they see what it costs and decide what they want. You see, it's all this, folks, is decision away. You know what? I made that decision. And since I made that decision, my life changed. And I want yours to change, too. And right on the side of that button is a guide that's going to show you a vehicle that will carry you there. Now, can I say, hey, you going to make $1 million in 30 days? No, but I will tell you this. I'll promise you this. When you go back and hit that button and get started, Joanne and I will be right there to help you. We'll give you step-by-step instructions of exactly what you need to do. But more important than that, I promise you, in 90 days, you'll be a different person. You won't be who you are right now. Because see, a lot of you out here right now, folks, like me, maybe you're living without hope. And there's nothing no more important in life is to see somebody and they call you up on the phone and say, thank you for changing my life. Hey folks, I really want you to see this for you. I won't do it for you, but I'll be with you step by step. Hey folks, just remember this, you're somewhere in the future and the future looks better than it does right now, but more important is, don't worry, be happy, hit the button, and I'll see you at the beach. And there we go.